finally have someone who can do it. And what do? After what was a masterful debate performance, they make the story the next day about how there's Republican disunity. Paul Ryan makes the day after that strong debate a story about himself on a moral high horse, looking down on the plane of all the plebes. And I find that to be so disappointing and maddening. For the people of this country, for our Supreme Court that is on the line. And I don't know how Paul Ryan thinks his Better Way agenda is going to get through a Hillary Clinton administration. That's ludicrous. Absolutely ludicrous.
I totally agree. Monica?
Yeah, you know, when you look at the Trump phenomenon, it's actually the latest iteration of the Tea Party movement, which is the grassroots groundswell of regular, everyday working Americans who wanted to believe in the Republican Party, and yet time and again, the GOP have let them down. They sent droves of Republicans to Washington in wave elections, 2010, right, 2014, and even before that. There would not have been the need for a Tea Party movement. There would not have been a Donald Trump candidacy if the Republican Party had stayed true to its core objectives and core principles of limited
government, I'll tell you this.
Fiscal responsibility.
I think that old Republican order is dead. It's not coming back. It is over. And Paul Ryan won't be Speaker very long. I can predict that,
and
too.
And look, the GOP establishment doesn't get it, or they don't want to get it.
Right.
And they are now going to go extinct because this movement is not going away.